Well, welcome back to the shop, you guys. Look what I have here this time. I have an old school lamp. And I'm gonna put it together and fire it up for the first time. I don't know how old it is, but it's an antique. And get my shop glasses here so I don't get any sawdust in my face and my eye. All right, so I found this at the local thrift shop, right? And look at it. I know it's old. I can't tell how old though. I mean, maybe somebody out there, one of you guys can tell me. Now this is very thin, very lightweight glass. I can tell that it's not, unless it's been replaced or they just built it this way, but it's very lightweight, this thing's very fragile. So I'm gonna put this thing down, but you can see, I'll show you the top part detail there. Can you see that detail? It has like raised, I don't know, some raised detail there. Maybe you guys, maybe somebody out there knows. Okay, so I'm gonna put that there. Now this part here, the only marking that I can see, it looks like a 1-9. See the one easy.
What?
If you look closely, look at that top. I mean, to me, if it looks older than the 29, there's rust on here. You know, there's some rust on these parts, on these tabs going up. So let's take it off. I can see that it has, now this is a, they call it 7/8. Some people call it the 3/4 wick. All right, so let's take this wick off. And there's no visible sign of any printing or any markings on here. It's thin metal. It is rusty, but it works. I mean, look at this. It goes up and down fine. There's nothing wrong with that. Works nice and easy. And this has a little cap, just a clear cap. So what we're left with here, you guys, is just this. I don't know. What do you guys think of this? Is it old? I'd like to think it's old. I paid, it was $18, right? And I went to the counter and I said, hey, is this the best you guys can do on this? She goes, you know what? Today is Senior Citizens Day and I'm gonna give it to you for half off. So I said, all right, I'll take it, fine. Awesome. So what we're gonna do today is I ordered up some of this, I ordered blue. Now I have clear over there. I have a clear lamp oil. I have a couple of them over there. Then I found this paraffin lamp oil. I know that I don't want to have this in a spot where it'd be enclosed and breathing the off gases of this thing. Just because paraffin, I don't, you guys tell me if it is toxic or not. I think it probably is. And I know that they have that clean fuel, whatever that is. And I'm ordering the clean fuel, the clean burn for, look at this, my Dietz little wizard that I found. And we'll get into that too. So that'll probably end up going inside, but I gotta clean that up first. Okay, that's from the 50s, I believe. But I wanted to get this one done. And the reason I chose blue or a color at all is just because obviously you could see a color. I could have put clear in there, but I'm fancy, right? All right, if I can figure this thing out, must be like a medicine. You gotta push it down to get in there. Come on now. What? Look at you guys. Look at me struggling here. Hold on. What are they doing here? It says, yeah, push down and turn. I've been doing that for 10 minutes now. You guys, what am I missing? I mean, am I gonna have to cut into this? Look, it clicked. Oh, it looks like there is there's a cap. You know, like when you unscrew the milk, a gallon of milk, and it has that retaining clip, like, I don't know, washer part of the cap that comes off. Well, this does too. I don't know. Looks like that's what was holding it. All right, let's see if we got it now. There it is. Yeah, see that? That's all that was holding. It was all bound up in there. All right, so I'm going to put this in. No fragrance. Here we go. It says danger. Contains petroleum distillates. Harmful or fatal if swallowed. Call the poison control and all this. Wash with soap and water. It says, I'm looking for made in. It's drydelcompany.com. European made. Oh, that's fancy. All right, let's put this in there. And then, oh yeah, I gotta put the, I'm gonna get rid of this wick and put on a wick from here. Okay, so let's go. Now, I don't plan on using this in any other lamp because all my other lamps, you can't see the fluid, you know, because, you know, obviously in here you can't see it. In my other ones, you can't see the fluid. So since this is a container that you can see fluid in it, why not just put the blue or whatever? I mean, they have all the different colors, the orange, the blue, the red. I'm just going to put a little bit in there because I don't know how long that's going to sit in there. All right, so let's get this cap back on. Now I'm going to move you guys in a little bit closer so that I can go over this right here. All right, I'm going to move you down. Okay, so this thing, it's real cheap. I tried to find some of these things locally and I couldn't in a pinch. So I just got it. I ordered them and I can't stand where I ordered them from, you guys. We all use that website every day and I wish we didn't have to. But anyway, this comes with, it's 6.5 feet per roll. It's a cotton wick, 1/2 inch, 3/4 inch, and 5/8, and 7/8. So there's 4 rolls in here and they're all just a little different. And that's all right because I have different lanterns that I'm gonna use these on, right? So right there, look at, see the small, medium, and I believe this is the one we're gonna use right here, this 7/8. So what I'm gonna do is just go ahead and roll this right on out. Make sure that we have a 7/8, or is it the 5/8? Ooh, looks to me like the 5/8, you guys, look at. It's right there. Where the 7/8 looks a little bit wider. Now I can use both, but I just have to make sure that it's gonna fit in through, you know, and pass through the opening there. And I'm looking through here and the teeth in there look good. And they'll just grab it and they'll grab and go. But I'm gonna go ahead and see if, let's go with this 5/8 first. Oh, look at that, they put a little nail in there, a pin to keep it pinned. Now I'm just gonna feed a little bit in here just to see that it fits and there's nothing, you know, no issues. Let's feed this in here. I'll bring it your way. Look at that, it just grabs it right away, feeds it in. Look at that, right there. So let's go with, I don't know, a few inches here. Let's do that and just so it gets down into the wick. We're gonna say, no, 10 inches here. And I'll use this old busted, come on. I'm trying to use this old razor blade here, you guys. You know what? Hold on. I have just the thing. If you remember when I was putting that new snowplow cutting edge on the snowplow and I said we'll be using this rubber deflector, this is what I meant. We're gonna be using it for things like this. So as a cutting board, right? Okay, now, perfect. Now that pin that I just pulled out of there is probably underneath the cutting board. Oh, here it is. So check it out, they give us this little tiny pin. Okay, little tiny pin. And I'm just gonna shove that right back in there on an angle, the way it was. And put it with the other ones. All right, so look, we are up and down, right? So I was told, now you can trim these, you guys, in different ways, and it's recommended that you trim these. What I've found out, let me get my scissors, is if you trim flat, you know, if you just trim the top off flat, you get a even burn, okay? Steady, even burn. Well, some people can trim on a, you know, round. If you do that, you get more of a, kind of a rounded middle burn. And some people go and just cut off the corners and you get like a pointier flame. And I guess that's the brightest flame, is when you just, you know, bring it to a point. I don't know. I'm just going to go ahead and look, it's, let's leave it the way it is right now and burn it, okay? And see what happens. Might not even have to do any trimming. Again, I'm not putting this in the house right now anyway. It's probably gonna stay out in the shop or something, and it might just be for power outages or, you know, if I just feel like having a fire out here. Okay, so that wick is gonna start pulling that up through there. I'll bring it down. Some of these wicks, they say, have a piece of copper woven inside there. And what that does is, if you're gonna burn heavier or thicker, a thicker fluid, oil, that heat that would go down would help the viscosity of it to rise up into the wick. But you know, with this being so thin and viscous, don't need that, obviously, but there is no copper wire in this one. It looks like, I'm trying to look down through there, it's picking it up. It's picking it up, you guys. So let's, okay, we're right here now. So why don't I soak this down a little bit? A little bit on each side, right? Just until I can see that it's connected. All right, that's connected. And it's starting to soak through on this side too. All right. I think we're onto something now, fellas. Okay, let's see. Back down. All right, let's try it. We'll bring it down, way down. See what kind of trouble I can get myself into. Huh. Look at that. Burning across there. What I'm doing right now is just looking at the flame. See how tall it is? They say when it gets too tall, it'll you don't want it soot. There, it's starting to even a little bit. Let's put the glass top on it. See if it evens out or what it's gonna do. Now I had to squeeze these tabs in because when I was messing with it the other day when I picked it up, this thing was really loose, floppy, so I squeezed these in. The reason that I have this and have this lantern here and, you know, my Coleman and all these other things that I like to collect, you guys, is because these are all going to be very so important, essential, right, items for grid down type situations. What if there's a storm? What if there is a different kind of storm and power is gone, right? Candles, those are great and all that stuff. These do better than candles. I use candles as a backup, or if I don't feel like firing one of these up, and we just lost power just not long ago, just a couple weeks ago, we just lost power for a little while. And I ran down and grabbed my power outage kit and fired up some candles, and it was nice. It was pleasant. It was great. This is just another backup. These things put out more light, especially these. Once I get this one cleaned up, this is going to put out a ton of light too. This one's safer to use than this one here because of obviously this thing is tippy. There's no real protection on it, right? So wherever this thing goes, whether it's going to stay out here in the shop or go, you know, next to the bonfire, campfire pit or wherever, you know, it's I like backups is what I'm saying. Backups to have some sort of good alternative power light source. Tiny bathroom, this might throw a little bit of heat. I mean, plus it's just pleasant. You know, sometimes I like to have, like I said, the lights down low and read with one of these things going. I just like it. Have a little coffee going, have one of these things going. It's kind of mesmerizing, right? If you don't want to build a big fire and... but I like these things. What do you guys think? Because we're going to need these things coming. There's a struggle ahead for all of us. And you need to be prepared for some things, you guys. Make sure that you have things like this. Very, very low tech, okay? Very low tech stuff that is going to be around. And these things will be your friend in those times. we've all been through storms and all these things, right? But it's going to get worse, I believe. 2024 is going to be a crazy year. We talk a lot about this kind of stuff over on my podcast. And my podcast doesn't go on here on YouTube or wherever you're watching this. You can find it on Rumble and, you know, more free speech friendly platforms. But I can't put it here on this channel because they would knock it down right away, right? It'd be gone on this channel. Just that, you know how it is. It's crazy. But if you guys are interested to know more about this kind of stuff that I'm tiptoeing around is what I'm doing. Go check it out. I have a co-host, Outcast. The podcast name is Dangerous Info Podcast. It's on all audio platforms, podcast platforms, and it's also on. It's a live show. It's a live Monday night show, Monday, 7 p.m. Eastern. And it's on Rumble and Twitter, Clout Hub, DLive, Twitch, and Pill.net, the Foxhole app. So it's, we've been doing that for 3 years now? Something like that. And we talk about all kinds of this stuff that will never be talked about here, you guys. We have a whole segment or many segments on a lot of these different shows about survival type prep kind of stuff that we're all going to need. And this is just one of them. Lighting, lighting is important. We talk, I'm talking from flashlights to these things, to candles, to, even the landscape lights that we all have outside. All those little things come in handy, right? It's very smart though to practice with the things you have, right? I always tell people, you don't know what you are going to need until the situation hits. So whenever you lose power, take advantage of it. Make notes and remember what it is that your family was lacking during that power outage. And work on that. Fill those needs. Buy the things or acquire the things that you are going to need, you and your family will need. The best thing that I tell people is, and it's hard to do, come home on a Friday night and let everybody know, hey, power's going off. Hit that main breaker, turn it all off, and don't turn it back on until Sunday. Now, it's going to be annoying to the younger kids in the house because they're going to all freak out about their Wi-Fi and all that nonsense, right? But it's going to show you and your family, your wife, whatever it is, the kids, what you're going to do in a situation where there's no power. Multiple days. It's a good prep because you're going to find out, you're still going to be able to shower. You're still going to have water. Are you city water? Are you a well water family? How are you going to be able to cook? Can you cook? Do you have an electric stove? Do you have a gas-fired stove? Do you have, ability to cook outside? You got to have all those bases covered. How are you going to shower? How are you going to keep your refrigerator cold? So these are it's a good exercise. Turn the power off. Let everybody know you're doing it and say, look, we have to work together. Figure this thing out. Come up with plans. And then, you know, you do that on a Friday, and then Saturday night or Sunday morning or whatever, it's up to you. Figure out what you were lacking when the power was out and make a plan. I'm telling you guys, we're all going to need it. And then you're going to need stuff to protect all your plan, right? So there's a lot of bases to cover. But anyway, if you're interested in that podcast, I please go check it out. It's Dangerous Info Podcast with Jesse James and Outcast. And again, I'm not putting it on here. I can't put it on this channel here that you're watching, YouTube, because that's not it's not free speech platform. We have to tiptoe around all the stuff. So there's still a lot of things that cross over, though, that very important. And this, I think, is one of them. Listen, you guys, I appreciate you guys for hanging out with me here today and kind of, you know, listening to what I have to say and, you know, watching me mess with this little thing here. So think about getting yourself one of these, getting something for your family. We'll be doing this one next. So stay tuned, and you know, if you're not already subscribed and if you're not hitting the notification bell, you won't get reminded of when I'm on here and doing this stuff. So please do those things, if you will, and please hit the like button. It helps the algorithms. I'm so sick of these algorithms, you guys, but this is where we're at, right? It's 2024, and I we have to look out for each other, because that's what's going to come down to. Wherever you live nearby, in your neighborhood, wherever you live around, it's going to be your people. So start making community with these people, right? Have barbecues. Do some things to get ready. There's so much communications and all that stuff that we have to go over. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoy this kind of stuff. And if you like what I was talking about there about the podcast and all this prep stuff and all these other things that we talk about, please, I invite you to go check it out. All right, until we see you again next time, stay dangerous, my patriot friends. All right, stay dangerous.